Hi, everyone, and welcome back to this week's edition of our Superintendent Report with Dr. Warren. Thank you so much for joining us today. How are you doing today?
Reese, I'm doing good. This is the first time you and I have done this.
Yes, sir.
Good. Very good. How's school going?
It's going really good.
Good.
All my classes are doing really good.
I'm wearing my red shirt today. We've got Northwest High School homecoming this week.
Yes, sir.
Right? Everybody ready for that?
Yes, we're really ready.
We have the parade. That'll be good.
Yes.
So good. School's going well?
School's going great. You know, got the grades up and all my classes are doing really good.
I'm sure your parents are thrilled about that, Reese.
Yes, sir.
What are we going to talk about today?
So the first question that everyone has been really wondering is, are we going to have prom?
Oh, that's a great question, Reese. So all parents and staff members and students received a family update from me about 2 weeks ago. Starting just this last Monday, so we're doing this on a Wednesday. This last Monday, we started a new set of COVID protocols that are geared to open back up our schools. So that we were very excited about that. Reese, we're tracking COVID numbers still every day. Since this whole thing started, you know, spring break of 2020, we have tracked our positive COVID cases every day. Our parents have teamed up with us, students have teamed up with us, and we're really doing a good job tracking the COVID cases in the district. As of the last, I think for the last 30 days, Reese, we've been under 1% total positivity rate for the district. So of all the people in the schools, 30,000 people, 27,000 students, 3,000 staff members, being under 1% positivity rate is fantastic. So we felt comfortable to start opening back up our schools to visitors, to parents. You know, we've got some kindergarten and first grade parents who have never gone to school to eat lunch with their kids and things like that. So we are opening up back up our schools. I don't want to jinx us, but the goal when we start back after Christmas, you know, we've got about 6 more weeks of this grading period before Christmas break. We really do hope we will be back to as normal as we can get it with the school business, school operations after Christmas. So that will mean we can go through the normal activities we've always done. And for you guys, especially for our juniors, our seniors who love the prom, who love, you know, and especially for our seniors with graduation, we are really, really hoping that COVID is hopefully now getting out of our lives and we will be able to have what we call normal activities like prom, like, you know, the graduation that we all do at UNT, things like that. So that's what we're hoping, praying for. Right now it's looking very good and we're going to continue to watch it. And like I said, we're coming off of our more restrictive COVID protocols that we've had to put in place over the last, you know, year and a half. And now hopefully we'll be able to have those normal things that are just important experiences to our students and for our families.
Right. That's really good. I know our seniors are going to be really happy about that one.
I would imagine so. Yeah.
With all the new changes going on, visitors and on campus, they can return?
Yes, as of this last Monday, we're allowing visitors to come back. We're allowing especially our elementary parents who love coming up to eat lunch with their kids. We're allowing that. So yes, we're going, you know, we got phenomenal PTA groups all across the district, 31 campuses. We have great PTAs, PTSAs. And so we are allowing more volunteers to come up. The volunteers that we have in our schools are so needed during the year. I mean, it has really been a detriment for us not having those volunteer parents on there to, you know, helping teachers, helping principals. So we are getting, again, we feel comfortable because of everything you guys are doing, students are doing to protect themselves, teachers, staff, and families. Everything is working right now, and that's why our numbers are going down. And so we feel comfortable doing that.
That's really good. Sounds like really good news.
Hopefully that's really good news to a lot of people. The only thing we've got to do, Reese, is we've got to stay vigilant about protecting ourselves and so it won't come back.
Yes, sir. I completely agree with you.
Amen.
With 2023, if there's any new schools coming up, new plans, new names for the new schools?
Reese, during my superintendent show over the last year, we've talked a lot about the bond program that passed, the building program. You know, Reese, we're we're growing almost 2,000 new children a year now. And so there's a lot of spaces that we've got to create to have that many kids in the district. So, and that's a great challenge to have. In the fall of 2023, so not this next fall, but the next one, we will have four new elementary schools and one new middle school coming online. So that'll be an exciting time for everybody.
Yes, sounds great.
We will have two that will be replacement campuses. The old Seven Hills Elementary School will get a brand new building, so it'll still be Seven Hills. Mm-hmm. And then the old Hatfield Elementary, which is just right over here by my office, right there by the high school, it will get a new building, and it'll still be named Hatfield. And then we have three brand new buildings, again, for growth, that we will put in place. We will have an elementary, do we know where the Sendero Ranch is? Sendero Ranch is right kind of in the middle of our school district, and it will have a brand new elementary school, and we're calling it Molly Livenwood Carter. That's a long name. But Carter Elementary School will be in that subdivision. It's called the North Star Development. Molly was actually a graduate of Northwest High School back in the day. She was an educator, a longtime family. Her family originally settled that part of our district. And tragically, she passed away at a very young age of cancer. And so we're going to honor her and honor her family. And we'll have Carter Elementary School in the North Star subdivision. And then we have another elementary school going up in Northlake. I mean, Northlake area is growing out of this world. And so in Pecan Square, we will have an elementary school named Daniel Elementary School. Johnny was a longtime developer in this one, worked with a developer company called Hillwood that is a big developer in this part of the country. And he's always a longtime supporter of the district and he and his family. So I think his brother was also a school board member at one time. So we're very honored to have Daniel Elementary School. And then middle school number 7, which will become open in 2023, C.W. Worthington. Worthington Middle School will be in the Laterra division, and that's right there off of Avondale Hazlett in the community of Hazlett. Mr. Worthington was a school board member, like from 1965 to 1975. And so he was a longtime family member, longtime community leader of the school district. So we're very honored to have his name on our newest middle school. So it's going to be exciting that time. You know, we're going to continue to work through the bond package. There's a lot of work to be done. You know, we have over $700 million of facility work to do. And so the biggest thing we're proud of is we're proud to have these families' names on our buildings and just, you know, to honor them for being supporters all this time.
Yeah, I love how meaningful the names are.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
So with Academy Taurus coming up, how will that work this month?
Again, what you and I just talked about, we feel comfortable opening up the schools. So we want to get back to, you know, and the academies, and you know, this academy, our STEM academy here at Northwest, and then we have the academies at Eaton and Byron and at Steele. We want to give our middle school students as much immersion into those academies and the information, because these academies are fantastic with what we're able to offer to students. And it really goes down, Reese, to allowing you to do what you want to. You just told me you may want a career in this, right?
Yes, sir.
And so we are very proud to give you this experience to get you started in this. And hopefully you will be ahead of the other students if you, whatever college that you choose, you'll be ahead of the game. And you already know a lot of the things going into the media world to be able to do that. So that's why it's so important to have those different academies, so that the students will be able to sign up for things they want to take rather than me just telling you which courses you have to take just to graduate from high school. So being able to open up our schools and have those academy tours is very important in what we do. And so we're going to go again. We feel comfortable enough with the COVID numbers the way they are to be able to do that again this year. So we're excited about that.
Yeah, that's amazing news. I'm glad we're going to be able to do that this year.
I know, yes, ma'am.
A bunch of students look forward to that.
Good.
Well, that's all the questions I have. Is there anything else that you want to add?
No, I enjoy doing this every month, being able to do that. You know, we have students who we pick a high school every time I do this who submit questions. I think these were Steele questions. I think these questions came from Steele High School. So whichever high school is next, just tell them to submit more questions, and we'll get after it next month.
Perfect. Sounds good. Well, thank you so much for joining us on this edition of Superintendent Report with Dr. Warren. Stay safe, everyone, and we will see you next time.